Rory Charles Graham, better known by his stage name Rag and Bone Man, hit the charts 8 years ago with his first single. Since then, the singer from Uckfield has gone on to travel the world and sell out tours. But despite his global success, he still calls Sussex his home and likes nothing more than spending time with his family. Well, he met Natalie Boare at Herstmonceux Observatory to chat about his new album out this week, breaking into the industry, and so much more in this extended interview for ITVx.
His gravelly blues vocal is instantly recognisable. Rag and Bone Man shot to fame in 2016 with his debut album. And the Sussex star is back with new music. He joined me at the Observatory Science Centre, where he had previously filmed a music video.
What made you want to come here and shoot a music video?
I honestly didn't know it existed until I'd heard of it, but until my son had a school trip here and it was suggested that we filmed a piece for the Calvin Harris song here. And it's amazing. The acoustics alone are worth it.
You grew up around here and you still call this home. What is it about Sussex that you love so much?
I mean, it's great growing up here. It's great for like kids in general because they can't really get into too much trouble. It's just woods and trees and rivers and you know, that's how we want our kids to grow up, you know.
This latest album, the title track from it, is quite personal. It does touch on grief, but it is also quite uplifting.
Yeah.
Do you find that writing music helps you to process things that are going on in your life?
I think it does for everybody, to be honest. It has to be cathartic, otherwise what's the point? Yeah, but I'm one of those people that doesn't really write introspectively. It's all just on a plate. So when you hear my songs, you'll know what they're about.
And what do you want people to take away from this album?
It's kind of meant to be about hope, and it's meant to... I thought when I first started writing the record, I had a couple of songs, and regardless of kind of the weight of the lyrics or what, you know, what they might be about, I wanted a sense of uplifting, and I always had it in my mind about where when I'm playing live and how I want people to feel, not only just listen to the record but when they come to gigs, and that for that to translate from the record to live, and I think we did a good job, I hope.
You recently shot a music video in Margate. What was that like, and do you enjoy that part of the job?
It's a very, very interesting concept. Came up with by my friend Lawrence. And yeah, we really enjoyed filming in Margate. We've been there before, we played at Dreamland, and we filmed some of this in Dreamland as well. It's a process that, like, it takes a lot of time and a lot of thought, and in an industry now where I think music videos are kind of like a bit of a last thought because of, you know, people don't really watch MTV so much anymore, or at all. So I think music videos tend to be something that's sort of thrown together as a visual for the song, but I'm always a great believer that that should be a piece of art to go with the piece of art which is your song. So it's always about finding the right director, finding the right cast, and making sure that it's an idea that is at least semi-original, you know.
You're also going out on tour with this album.
Yes.
Can you remember what it was like the first time you performed for a huge crowd?
I think, yes. I remember getting the call to do support for Joan Armour Trading at the Brighton Dome, and that was the biggest crowd I'd done so far. I think up until then it was like a couple of hundred people, and this was a couple of thousand people. I love playing for big crowds. But there is something to be said for playing small gigs, and I still really enjoy that.
And you're going to have a gig at home as well, well, nearly home, Brighton.
Yes.
What's it like when you perform for that home crowd?
Oh, it's always great. I think people in Brighton have always got my back, and I never worry about what the gig's going to be like, because I sort of have this set in kind of confidence about a Brighton crowd. And plus there's loads of friends and family in the audience. So
you said that you feel confident when you're on stage, but in normal day-to-day life you don't feel as confident. How do you manage that struggle when it comes to believing in yourself?
I don't know, it's a difficult question. I think one of the reasons why I picked a name that wasn't my own is that I could be someone else on stage, because I'm not necessarily very extrovert as a person. And I think as long as you can sort of come to terms with that separation, then you're all right. Some people got the real problems. Some people out of love. Some people think I can solve them.
Lots of people will think that you had overnight success because your first album was such a huge hit.
Yeah.
But you really worked for it, didn't you?
Yeah, I mean, you know, for years and years before that, I would travel the length of the country with a guitar and do gigs for 4 cans of lager and probably less. It took a long time, but I don't blame people for thinking it was an overnight success, because for most people it was, you know, just for me it wasn't.
Do you think because you got signed later on in life that you were better equipped to deal with fame?
I don't really want to think about how it would have been if I'd have done it when I was like 18, 19 years old. I think it would have been a totally different story. So yeah, I am glad.
What were you doing before you were singing full time, and would you still be doing it if you hadn't got signed?
I had loads of different jobs, lots of rubbish ones. I worked in pubs, I was a removal man, I worked as a carer for quite a few years. That was probably the only job that I really enjoyed, and I probably would have stuck to it if I hadn't have been a musician.
How do you cope day to day with going to the supermarket, doing the school run, that kind of thing, when people recognise you?
I just do it now. And there are some times where, some days we don't really feel like having a picture with people, some days you don't really feel like talking to people, which everybody does in life. You know, I think you just have to try and manage it the best you can. Sometimes the reason people want to talk to you is because they want to say, this particular song helped me in some way, or I love this album because it means this to me, you know, and I think there's a certain amount of respect you have to give to people who are genuine fans that want to speak to you. So, you know, that's cool. I feel the thunder roll tonight, like a rush of blood. Oh, I
feel the thunder roll tonight, let the pressure go. How does it make you feel when someone tells you that a track that you've written has impacted them?
It's the best thing about it. It's, you know, it's the, like, when you write a song, it's yours, and then when you release it, it becomes everybody else's, and then it becomes, you know, a different meaning for everybody that listens to it. And you know, if that, the thing about music is, it can take you from a very uncomfortable situation to somewhere of calmness and peace. Like if you're in a situation where you might feel anxiety or something, and your way of dealing with that is listening to a piece of music, if I can do that for someone, that's the best thing about music.
Where do you get your musical influences from?
I am very lucky that my parents had a massively broad taste in music. Anything from like soul and funk music to folk music. And I was allowed to explore all the records and CDs that I wanted and listen to whatever I wanted and never discouraged to listen to anything. So yeah, I'm pretty lucky in that way.
You got to perform at the Team GB homecoming party. What was that like?
Intense. I felt very unfit looking at the crowd.
I think most of us would.
Yeah, right. No, it was really fun. It was a right honour to be asked, not just once but twice.
What has been your career highlight?
Wow. Do you know what? I think it is when you get to perform to a country or a crowd that you've never been to before, because I always see that as like a challenge. It's not often that it happens now because we proper little globetrotters and we go everywhere. But when you get to a country or an audience that you haven't performed to before and it goes well, that's like the best feeling ever.
I know family is really important to you and that you've embraced being a blended family.
Yes.
What do all the kids make of your success?
I thought that the little ones didn't understand it that much, but I think they do now. I don't know if they think I'm cool. Kind of hope they don't, because you know I'm their dad, so I shouldn't be cool. I should be embarrassing.
Rory, thank you so much for talking to me.
That's all right. Thank you.